So, how do we manage to live in harmony with one another as Christ, as believers in Jesus, when we're all so different, when we probably have different points of view? Well, when Paul talks about having the same mind, I don't think he especially means that we should always agree exactly with every other single person who is a Christian. But what it does mean is that there is that basic unity and that love and respect for one another, not the undermining and competitive kind of spirit that we tend to see generally in the world, in the society around us. Living alongside one another in peace doesn't come naturally to us, but God helps us to be humble and to forgive. God gives us the insight to recognize the tendencies within us to want to be first or to control others. Let's just submit these traits to Jesus, asking him to cleanse us in his precious blood and submit ourselves to God. We'll notice more and more of those old nature things within us. But don't get discouraged. We just keep on. Jesus didn't agree with his disciples for a lot of the time, and yet he still managed to live at one with them, in unity with them. That's interesting, isn't it? He had that forgiving and loving heart that basically was not divisive, but always very, very uniting. And so let's surrender our lives now to Jesus Christ. Let's worship him. Let's allow the Holy Spirit to fill us and to help us to live like him and to be like Jesus. Amen.